So it seems that 2023 is gonna be the year of DaVinci Resolve. I feel like every single day that I'm on Twitter, I'm seeing a new big creator coming to test out the beauty of Resolve. Welcome, you made the right decision. One of the biggest things I love about Resolve is how often they are coming out with updates. And as we are fully into 2023, spring is gonna be here in no time, and that's usually when we start to see a new version of DaVinci Resolve. So in this video, I wanna give my 5 biggest feature requests to Blackmagic, because I know you're listening out, obviously, that I would love to see in DaVinci Resolve 19.
The original sponsor of this video, I haven't heard back from them. So you know what? I'm the sponsor of today's video, and I'd appreciate if you listen to my quick message here.
I'll place a bet that almost every video editor out there, including you, have been pressured in to make the switch to DaVinci Resolve. And I promise you, there are quite a few reasons why so many creators have been making the switch this year. But one of the biggest issues of making the switch is the time it takes to learn a new program. You can make the switch within a couple of hours. I've now helped over 500 creators make the switch and learn DaVinci Resolve. In my beginner course, you're going to learn the general interface, where everything's at, how to customize it to your liking. I give you tons of 6K and 12K B-Raw sample footage just to show you how powerful and efficient Resolve can be on almost any type of computer or iPad. I make contacting me directly with questions as simple as clicking a button. And as new features are released, I will be making new videos added to the course. It has never been easier and more cost-effective to switch video editing programs. I promise you it's not gonna take weeks. So come join my members area. I'll see you in there. The first one I'm a little angry at because I've been requesting it and it seems so silly that it's not already a thing. But on the cut page, we need the ability to adjust video and waveform sizes, just like you do on the edit place. If you've been a long viewer of this channel, you've heard me rant about this dozens of times. It is the single reason that I do not use the cut page as much as I would love to. The cut page has so many cool features, but as someone who primarily edits while looking at audio waveforms, it's next to impossible. And don't be one of the people who comments, well, they have the audio waveform like zoom cut thing feature. In order to use that, you have to like click the clip and drag it around and trim, and that's not how most of us edit. Next up, I would love to see a fully optimized version for iPad. And I've been using all of the pages on DaVinci Resolve for my lovely iPad ever since then, but you can definitely tell it's still in like the hack stage. It's not an official thing. Every time you open the app, you have to return on the shortcuts and not all the pages are optimized and whatever. So it'd be really cool if they just said, hey, we weren't gonna do it this early, but we've optimized all the pages, so you now have full DaVinci Resolve on the iPad. So the next one isn't DaVinci Resolve itself, but actually a utility that works when you get DaVinci Resolve, and that is the Proxy Generator. This is a really cool tool, especially if you have like a Blackmagic Cloud store. What it will essentially do is it's almost like a watch folder where when you put in raw footage, it will automatically create proxies for that, that if you have remote editors or you just wanna edit mobily with much smaller files, it's really cool. But right now, all it will do is create proxies within the same folder that your raw footage is. What I would personally love to be able to do is import the raw footage to my main drive in my Mac Pro or even on my archive, and then have proxies go to the cloud store so Michelle can access, or a remote editor. Basically just simply being able to choose where I can put proxy generator stuff. Number 4, I think it's time. I think we have enough computing power to, when we export a video, it can export in the background while we continue to work in the program. There's a lot of video apps do this. Heck, Final Cut does it. Because I tell you, one of my workflows is a lot of times I'll use this camera to shoot the thumbnail. So say I'm doing a video on my Blackmagic or something, I do my talking A roll, and then at the end I'll just make bunch of the stupid YouTuber faces right at the camera, and then I end up pulling a still and creating a thumbnail out of that. But what happens most of the time is I export the video and it starts rendering, and then I go, oh, I didn't export the still first so I could work on that in Photoshop while the video is rendering, but then I don't want to cancel the render, and it's a whole thing. So if it could just export in the background, I could hop to the color page, export the still, keep doing some things within the project. That would be amazing. And finally, number 5, this would be, I think, probably the biggest headlining news, would be even more features with the Blackmagic Cloud. They announced this last year. They announced so many collaboration features, and we finally got introduced to the Blackmagic Cloud databases, which has been probably the biggest game changer for me in my entire workflow. The fact that I can literally go to any machine and access my projects is incredible, but you obviously need the raw files and all your assets on a hard drive with you. So I can go to Michelle's laptop and look at all my projects, but unless I have the footage for those projects on a drive, then it's obviously useless. It would be amazing if they added actual cloud storage to their plans. And obviously that would cost more than $5 a month. But I feel like with where storage is nowadays, if you look at like Google Drive, Dropbox, you can get up there. I mean, like 3 to 5 terabyte plans for 25, 30 bucks, maybe. If I could upload raw footage to Blackmagic servers, and then here's where like the feature would go like next level. I don't know if this is possible at all, but if I could then go to any computer, open up DaVinci Resolve, and then log into my account, I'd see all my projects. There'd be some button to be like download footage or download project assets that would have everything I need. And I could either download the true raw originals, or it could create proxies in the cloud. And so if I had 250 gigs worth of like a YouTube video project uploaded, if it could generate proxies and then download, you know, 10 to 20 gigabytes worth of those proxies, and then I can work with the projects, get home, export out the raw files or download them if I really needed to. Sure, they partnered with Dropbox and Google Drive for their like cloud store to do backups and stuff, but I want to see a first party solution, because Blackmagic has really become, in my opinion, like Apple, where they're creating this beautiful walled garden of an experience that is so just amazing for every consumer, from pricing models to updates and features. Like, I love shooting on my Blackmagic camera, putting the footage on a Blackmagic hard drive that's connected to a network, which then goes into Blackmagic's DaVinci Resolve. Anyways, those are my top 5 features that I'd love to see in the upcoming version of DaVinci Resolve. Let me know down in the comments below, what are some features, bug fixes, whatever you would like to see from DaVinci Resolve 18 to 19. Thanks so much for watching. See you guys in the next video.